Hi everyone. We've been asked to do a few tips, focusing more on the thinking in the game as opposed to the shooting. If you haven't seen them, we have a number of master's tips that have been posted on the internet here for a couple of years that focus more on the selection of your cue, stance, grip, and a lot of the different shooting techniques. But in these next few segments, we want to focus on the thinking. And philosophically, let me tell you that in pool, it's more, in my opinion, it's more thinking than it is the physical aspects. Whereas you take some other sports, it's the other way around. For example, in tennis, it doesn't take a lot of brains to know where you want to hit the ball. You want to hit the ball where your opponent isn't. It's just hard to do it, okay? In pool, let's face it, we're just moving our right arm or our left arm, and it's a hand-eye coordination thing. But in pool, what I found is there's so many things that people don't know. And if they learned more, they would improve their game. The first thing that I wanted to talk about was analyzing the table. Again, this is mainly for advanced players, fives, sixes, and sevens. But you know, as you play good players, you sixes and sevens and you fives, you know that if you run down to where you've only got one ball on the table or the eight ball on the table and you don't actually get out, you don't actually win the game from there on that particular shot, you know that you're at a serious disadvantage. Even if you're playing a two or three, all of a sudden the odds might tip in your opponent's favor. So the key is this analysis, and you have to be correct. I'd recommend, for example, that you even keep some stats on yourself on how often you say that you're going to get out and how often that you actually do it, because that's important. And you will find that as you improve your percentages of running out, obviously you'll be improving your results. So you have to be able to analyze a table. One of the greatest players I ever knew, his name's Larry Hubbert, he always said, and I think he's so right, that eight ball, unlike nine ball, is a little like poker, because you get dealt a hand and your opponent gets dealt a hand. And keep in mind that the hand that you're dealt could be more difficult than the hand your opponent was dealt, and therefore it's important to analyze both of the sets of balls that are out there, yours as well as your opponent's. For example, if you look at this table, and I look at I'm the solids, and I've got this four ball right here. It's in an impossible position. I also don't have a ball on the table here that's an easy breakout where I can actually go over there and break it out. You can see that. But on the other hand, my opponent does, because my opponent with his 15 ball, for example, or this 13 could get an angle on it and go over and break it out. Therefore, I cannot assume that just because I can't get out, my opponent can't get out. The point here is when you analyze the table, not only of your balls, but analyze your opponent's balls too. And then the other part of the tip here is you have to recognize your own abilities and your own limitations. When you decide you're going to get out, you need to be right. Because if you try to get out and you don't, you are now at a significant disadvantage in that particular game. So the analysis of the table is the important thing. This is something you can work on with your teammates and get better and better at it.
You don't have to play like a pro to enjoy the game I love.
If you've ever played in a friend's basement, you can compete in an APA league. In the APA, everyone can play and anyone can win. So if you're looking for a fun night out with your friends and family, join an APA pool league today. Have fun, meet people, play pool. Visit poolplayers.com today.